Hey guys, my name's Andy, and today I'm going to show you the LGS file type and the JetStream viewer. An LGS file can be any kind of point cloud that was processed with Leica software. And the JetStream Viewer is the fastest way to view these point clouds. The JetStream Viewer is completely free and you can download it from the Leica site. I'll put a link in the description so you can download it for yourself. The best thing about it is that it's blazing fast. There's virtually no import or rendering time needed. Everything is pretty close to instant, even with really large clouds. Another really cool feature about the JetStream Viewer is that there's a portable version that doesn't even need to be installed on your computer. It can run completely on a flash drive. This makes it really useful to be able to throw the JetStream Viewer and the LGS file on a flash drive, send it to a client, and they can open it up without having to install anything. So I've gone ahead and created an LGS file for you to check out. So I'll put a link in the description so you can download it and do the same thing with me. So I've got this LGS file here on my desktop, and I've already got the JetStream Viewer installed, so now all I have to do is double click this. It opens up the viewer, and now I can see a top-down view of my site. I can get rid of this map by minimizing that, and then here I'm instantly viewing the cloud. So it's super easy. Using the left mouse button, I can rotate around a single point, and then using the right mouse button, I can pan around. I can get rid of this little sitemap down here by clicking on this button. And then I can also get rid of these individual stations by clicking on this scan locations button. So now I can go through, I can zoom into the building, check out anything that I want to see. And if I want to turn on the scan locations again, I can turn these back on. And if I double click on them, I can zoom in, and now I'm viewing the images from this scan position. So then I can bounce around through the house. When I'm in the position of a scan, I'm kind of like locked in this scan position. But if I want to rotate back through the cloud, I can switch to this orbit tool, and then I'm viewing everything in 3D. Another really cool tool is this fly-through feature. So if I toggle that on, I can click and hold, and I'll start to fly through the cloud. I can scroll back to slow down, scroll up to speed up. I can also change how I view the cloud. I can switch the colorization here. I can do the hue intensity, so this is the laser intensity of each point. And then I can also switch to grayscale. This sometimes can make the clouds look really, really nice. Moving down the line, there's these quick clip tools where you can really quickly create a small limit box. So if I want to separate something from everything else, I can go and really quickly focus in on something in particular. And the very next tool down the line is this measurement tool. So if I toggle that on, I can click two points in the cloud, and it'll give me the distance between them. If I want to get rid of that measurement, all I need to do is make sure I'm still in that measurement mode. Click again, it'll get rid of it. And the next tool here is the temperature measurement. So if you have a BLK 360 data set where there's a thermal image, you can go into one of the images and take a temperature measurement. So if I go into the house here, this is the normal image, but I can toggle on the IR image. So now I can view this IR data. And I can choose the measure temperature tool and then measure the temperature of anywhere in this image. So now I'm gonna toggle back to the normal image. The next couple tools are screenshot tools. So I can take a screenshot of anything on the screen. It'll be copied to my clipboard. And then this is video tool. So if I click this, I can choose where to save it, and then it'll start a video recording of a fly through or whatever you want to do in your point cloud. So that was it. JetStream is an extremely easy to use program. Not a ton of features, but it really packs a punch when you need it. I personally like to always have it open when I'm working with AutoCAD or Revit because it's really quick to jump into JetStream to take a couple quick measurements. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.